In this day and age of tech, you can't blink without missing something. So I wouldn't at all be surprised if you missed the little cameo wow that Dolby Atmos Flex Connect made during a recent TCL announcement. I mean, I almost missed it. Perhaps that's why nobody is talking about it. Or is there maybe another reason? Welcome back, everyone. I'm Caleb Dennison, and today I want to take a closer look at this new Dolby Atmos Flex Connect technology. Perhaps you missed the news. I'm sure a lot of folks did. Or perhaps you're not sure if it's worth getting excited about. And trust me, I get that. But given the kind of power that Dolby has in the industry and the fact that at least TCL seems pretty on board, I figured it's worth a quick conversation. A conversation that I'm sure will inspire you to like, comment, and subscribe so that I can achieve my goal of total YouTube tech domination. Thanks kindly for your support. I won't forget it when the apocalypse begins. So let's start by learning what Dolby Atmos Flex Connect is. For that, let's take a look at what Dolby says it is. Now, according to Dolby, and I quote here, Dolby Atmos Flex Connect unlocks the freedom to place one or more wireless speakers anywhere in a room without having to worry about perfect placement. Okay, so far I get it. The idea is that not every room is set up so that you can have perfect speaker placement. You can see that in the graphic that they use. Oh, sweet mercy, they're moving a TV into the corner. Well, there goes all your plans for good sound. I'm exaggerating, of course, but we audiophiles sure do love our symmetry. Actually, it's the laws of acoustics that love symmetry, but I digress. I mean, this is a relatable issue. Also, power outlets aren't always where you need them, and running wires is a hassle too. So it looks like Dolby Atmos Flex Connect is meant to help us work around those challenges. That's a solid idea. I mean, what was the movie? I think it was Robots, where the fat robot voiced by Mel Brooks says,
"See you need felony."
Okay, we have a pretty solid premise, folks. Now, what does Dolby say next? By combining additional accessory devices with your TV speakers, Dolby Atmos Flex Connect unlocks the best sound performance. Okay, hold on there. What are additional accessory devices? Why so vague? Weren't they just wireless speakers before? Maybe subwoofers? I mean, but what else? And then they said, unlocks the best sound performance. Well, that's just a bold marketing claim. It'll unlock potentially better sound performance. Let's be realistic though, the best sound performance is gonna cost a small mint, so maybe we just ease up on the hyperbole, Dolby. Then they say, whether you're adding a single speaker for some extra punch or multiple speakers to create a fully immersive experience. All right, see, now this is where I start getting concerned, but I'll get to that in a second. I think we get the idea so far though, right? Dolby Atmos Flex Connect is a technology that will reside in a TV, potentially some other source devices, but for now we'll just say it's a TV, and it will be able to connect to wireless speakers, be it one or however many, we don't know how many yet, and then it will use a microphone in the TV to determine the location of the speakers relative to the TV, and then use those wireless speakers in concert with the TV speakers to create a Dolby Atmos surround sound effect, whether it's one speaker or multiple speakers that you're using. Well, frankly, that's gonna sound absolutely fantastic to a lot of folks. I mean, just put the speakers where you can put them, whether you've got one, two, or nine of them, and then boom, Dolby Atmos is happening. I mean, a lot of people are gonna want that, but why am I still so skeptical? I'm gonna tell you, but before I get into that, I wanna talk a little about Dolby Atmos in general. It is my opinion, and that's all it is, it's my opinion, that Dolby Atmos is now more brand than technology. Don't get me wrong, there's a lot of technology that goes along with Dolby Atmos, but the way Dolby Atmos is treated now, it's just a symbol that's supposed to suggest quality audio. See, when Dolby Atmos first came out, Brave was the first movie that had it for a little timestamp. It was very clearly the name for a new object-based surround sound. It was very exciting. You could hear it in the theaters, and if you had an advanced enough system, you could hear it at home as well. But now, a TV with two tiny, dinky speakers has Dolby Atmos? I mean, guys, come on. I get that you can fake surround sound, even with two terrible TV speakers, but you really want to slap the Dolby Atmos brand on that? Anyway, enough SMH. My point is that Dolby Atmos doesn't stand for one certain thing anymore. It's a brand that's meant to signify good audio. So is Dolby Atmos Flex Connect then meant to bring home that dome of sound experience, or is it just supposed to be better than crappy TV speakers? Well, actually, if this little trailer for it is anything to go by, then it's supposed to be the big dome of sound thing. But since Dolby Atmos doesn't really signify a level of audio quality or a level of surround sound, I think we should probably manage our expectations a little bit, just a little. We could end up being surprised at what it does, but let's not expect cinema level sound here, at least not with just one or two wireless speakers. Here's what worries me about Dolby Atmos Flex Connect. Details are still really vague, like worryingly so for something that was announced and shown off at the world's biggest consumer electronics show. Also, who is making these wireless speakers that you can use? Is it Bluetooth? It better not be, so I don't think that just any Bluetooth speaker you have kicking around the house is gonna work, unless Dolby is licensing out some kind of wireless adapter you could add to them. Nah, I think we're going to see purpose-built speakers for this system. Flex Connect-enabled speakers, perhaps. And what will those look like? Will they have up-firing drivers, or are these meant to be more multi-purpose wireless speakers? I've seen some footage from IFA in which a TCL TV was driving a Flex Connect system using, I think they were called 2T Coral speakers. But will TCL make some wireless speakers of its own? Can anyone just make them if they want? I suspect so, since Dolby usually licenses out its technology to whomever's gonna pay. I'd just like to see some details on this though. Also, this is gonna take some really serious algorithmic processing. Otherwise, it is 100% gonna sound mid. Like, if you're promising you can put the speakers anywhere and you can use as many or as few as you like, the processor inside the TV, which will be licensed by Dolby and thus will cost money and then thus will raise the price of the TV, that processor is gonna have to do some miraculous wizardry in order to adapt the sound it's sending out wirelessly to work within the unique set of conditions in the room and the unique capabilities of each speaker in the room. I mean, that kind of computational audio is in Apple's warehouse, I suppose, but Dolby? You got it like that? I mean, I suppose they very much could, but it's gonna be some advanced next level stuff. Another concern is that the acoustic trickery involved in making balanced, enveloping sound no matter where the speakers are placed, that usually involves playing around with the phasing of that sound. That's where you intentionally place some sound signals out of phase so that they almost cancel each other out, but not quite. Now, this allows you to make the sound seem as if it's coming from everywhere or nowhere in particular, or from somewhere there isn't actually a sound source. Sometimes this kind of virtual surround sound can be very impressive, but often it comes at the expense of overall fidelity. So I have concerns about that too. I will say though that I once heard a DTS demo years ago in which they had speakers set up with very odd scattershot placement, and they pulled off one incredible surround sound demo. So it can be done. But even if this technology is scalable, as Dolby implies, how many speakers will you need for it to actually be like really good? Now, let's switch gears and assume the best for a moment. How's that for a change? Let's be positive. Let's assume that Dolby's completely adaptable, defies the laws of physics, does the impossible technology, really is that advanced. If it really is that amazingly awesome, then why is it flying under the radar right now? Well, maybe it's because the right folks haven't heard it yet. Nobody outside of those developing it or working on deploying it, or those who happen to go by the booth at IFA, have actually heard it in action. Hopefully Dolby starts offering some demonstrations. I'm reaching out to Dolby right now because I want in early on this. I mean, look, I've been working with Dolby for a long time, and I just think it's odd that they haven't been making a bigger deal out of this stuff. Yeah, they sent a press release out, but it seems like they are being kind of meek about this, which is not Dolby's usual vibe. Anyway, I guess maybe letting TCL make its announcement was the fringe benefit of being the first to adopt the technology. Maybe as Dolby signs on more partners or those partners get closer to releasing their products, we'll start to hear more about this. I hope so, because this sort of coming out with a whimper rather than a roar just doesn't fill me with confidence. But you know what? I'd love to be wrong about all this. I'd love for my skepticism to be completely misplaced. I hope to hear Dolby Atmos Flex Connect and then just be truly blown away. Because this really is something a lot of folks could use, a scalable, flexible system exactly as Dolby is describing it. The WiSA thing still hasn't taken off despite it being pretty awesome. Sonos is a locked up ecosystem and it's kind of pricey. Like, what we need is a wireless surround sound solution that lets us start small if we want, work our way up and get something awesome sounding no matter the level at which you're invested. So let's keep an eye on this and hope that the right players get into the game. I wanna see speakers from JBL, Yamaha, Klipsch. You listening, Klipsch? I'd ask for Polk, except I think they're wrapped up in a deal with DTS, but who knows. And then let's see some even more premium names in the home audio business get involved too. Maybe some upstarts could pop up around this. Sounds like an awesome business opportunity. But please, let's just not let this die and wither away into nothingness like so many other promised technologies that we've seen in the past. I'm not saying Dolby has a history of doing that. I just, like I said, I tend to be skeptical. I'll believe it when I see it, and I'll believe it when I hear it. Thanks as always for watching, everyone. What do you think about Dolby Atmos Flex Connect? Think it's real? Think it's gonna work well? Let me know down in the comments. I'm really curious to hear what you think. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I'll see you on the next one. And until then, here's two other videos I think you might like.